Hey everyone, today we're going to be talking about creating a dialog box, a pop-up on your Articulate Storyline page, and a new feature that makes it a whole lot easier. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, welcome back. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts where you can see different tips and tricks on learning developments on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, Camtasia, XAPI, and more. You can also download free templates in Articulate Storyline 360, as well as XAPI and video templates. And if you're new to any of these subjects, you can check out full courses, everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. Now, before this update inside of Storyline, I would create my own version of this. And let me show you what I was doing before and how this new feature makes it a whole lot easier. So I'm going to go into a page here. And let's say I have a page that's going to pop open a layer. So I'm just going to insert just a quick example here, just something really simple that's going to have a trigger. And that trigger is going to show a layer. Now, we don't have a layer created yet, so I'm actually going to have to close this window real quick and then add a layer. And this is going to be my information, or my dialog box, basically, my dialog information. Now, I could put this on a master slide and I could trigger that inside of the master slide. But for now, let's just stick within this page. On this, I'm going to go ahead and add this trigger to show the layer. Now, the layer is going to go on top of this base layer. So you have the main layer. This layer is going to show up on top of it. So let's select show layer here. Now, this is all pretty much what's been here before, as long as I can remember, at least. When the user clicks on rectangle one, it's going to show that layer. Now, this is what's a little bit different. So once I'm in this layer, even though it kind of looks grayed out to me, what's going to happen here, I'll show you what's going to, or what it's going to do. Let's just add a simple smiley face. That is going to show on top of that, but it's still going to be visible behind the scenes. So let's preview this slide here. So if I click on this button, it's pretty much like it sits on top of it, but it doesn't gray out the background or anything, which is fine if you want that look. But there were times where I wanted to gray out the background. So what I would do previously is I would go into this info layer. I would create an entire shape here to fill the entire screen. I would make sure that's on the bottom here. And then I would take the transparency of that shape and I would adjust the transparency. I would first of all make it black. So I'm going to make that black theme right here. And then I would adjust the transparency. That way it's see-through, but you're now focused just on what this content is. So let me show you what that the end result is and how this new feature makes it a lot easier. So if I click on this, you'll notice that it kind of fades out the background now. And now I'm focused specifically on that. I can still see what's in the background, but I'm more focused just on this here. Okay, so here is the easy part now. So if I go ahead and I delete that shape right there, I don't need that shape anymore. I think Storyline, there were so many people that were doing this that they decided to add this in as a feature, and they've enhanced some other things as well. So if you click on this layer and you go into this gear icon, this is what's changed, the behavior section. Now, there are a couple of things that have changed in the behavior section. The first one makes life a whole lot easier, and I'm so thankful that they've done this. If I select this drop-down box, I can select dialog. Notice what happens is it automatically grays out that background for me. I'm going to come back to these settings, but now let's preview what I was just doing before. And it's grayed out everything, and this is now showing as like a dialog, as some informational modal pop-up or something like that. So I'm going to click on that and notice how it's automatically grayed out. Saves me that one extra step, actually a couple extra steps of inserting the shape, resizing it, and changing the color, and then changing the opacity. So just about four extra steps basically right there. All right, now I'm gonna come into the gear icon and I'm going to adjust a couple of other things here. Now this, I haven't figured out what this part is and where this goes. This may be like a little label pop-up or something that pops up and a description that may be for the alt text. I don't know specifically. Honestly, I haven't read that, but I probably can click on this. Let's click on this real quick and see. Okay. So it is, the label is pretty much this screen reader text. So you can define the screen reader text as like whatever the title is of that modal. You can select that from the pop-up, which means that if I come in here and I add a title right here, some text right there, I can define that as being the label and the description, or I can just set it to none. So you could just basically, for the screen reader text, have this modal be a pop-up and have that read it there. Now, you also have the ability to pause the base layer, which you had before, but also because it is set as a dialog, the user is not able to click on anything on the main slide. If I went ahead and moved this back to a layer, notice that they can click on things, but I could still prevent them without showing that dialog. So that's really what's changed. It's something simple, but it saves me a couple of steps. I'm always happy to save a couple of steps when I'm duplicating or doing the same thing over and over inside of Storyline. And I wanted to make sure that I pointed that out because hopefully it saves you a couple of steps if you're doing the same thing. Now, just as a reminder, you can always check out more blog posts like this at my websites. If you go into the blog section, you can check out all learning and development blog posts. You can also download templates, free templates in Articulate Storyline 360. You can also check out full courses. If you're new to any of these topics, you can check out courses, everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 Video. And if you haven't already, go to my YouTube channel, click on that like button and subscribe to my channel and hit that bell notification. It really helps me and allows me to keep making these videos to hopefully help you in your job or as you're working with Articulate Storyline 360. You can also leave a comment. What else do you want to know about Articulate Storyline 360, XAPI, or just Custom SCORM or anything like that? I'm happy to help out there. That's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.